Welcome back to the Lean Discovery Applied series. I'm Clinton Sanko with my guest, Marc Zamsky, COO of Compliance. So Marc, I love the saying that's attributed to Peter Drucker, if you can't measure it, you can't improve it. And I think that eDiscovery is not immune from that basic point of wisdom. If you look at your client base, kind of at your entire client base, what are the common things that you're seeing your corporate clients measure to determine if they are actually improving their eDiscovery value and eliminating waste year over year? And are there any additional things that maybe they should be looking at going forward to start measuring so they can get a baseline and start looking at new metrics on a go forward?
I think one of the great things that a corporate counsel are doing today is reducing the number of providers that they're using. So whether that's ALSPs or law firms or third-party service providers, they are having very limited lists. So they have a much better handle on how much data they have and where that data sits. That's on top of the fact that so many companies are also starting to own or manage or subscribe on a SaaS basis to their own platforms. And so this is giving them great insight. And so for one, I think it all comes back to cost overall. For corporations, they are still seen as a cost center. I know so many of them want to try to build back, but I'm a big proponent of starting to measure real data and real data sizes. So I think, again, those AI and analytics platforms, business intelligence platforms that are wrapped around this concept of cost, right? What was our spend last year? What were our outlying litigation? How can we normalize things and how can we start continue to reduce cost? I think that we want to continue to implement data reduction strategies earlier in the process. I think data reuse, data lake strategies are incredibly important. And they all go back again to that understanding the data today and bringing that back to their IG and data retention policies. I think as we start to benchmark things like custodians, divisions, outside counsel, court decisions, all of that business intelligence gives us greater insight into how data is being used, how data is even being processed, how big was the set we turned over versus how big was the set that we produced, and what was ultimately utilized in depositions or in court. So the more that we're able to use what has happened in the past and the analytics that we've used and continue to pull that back into the process, I think that's where we have to start measuring. So again, data explosion, but moving less and less data into the system. Or if it's a matter of continuing to move more data into the process so we get greater insight, it's making sure that the cost structures that we have are not based on how much total data we're bringing in, but really how much data moves its way through the process. Because sometimes you need to collect from a number of custodians. Sometimes you don't want to run keyword searches too early in the process. I want to get the whole story. I want to see who's talking to who. I want to understand what all my potential concepts are, just in case this is a case that involves something that can't necessarily be identified through keyword. Maybe it's identified through a pattern of behavior or emotions, things that can be identified through a wide array or application of analytics against that wide array of data. And so I think that we look at the way data's moved through the process and how much that costs. So greater incentives to analyze data earlier on and costs that are reduced because we're able to reduce that cost as we move through.